Say hi.
Hello, I'm Jules from IQ Hackers.
Okay. Hi, I'm Josh Lim from likesbeforelove.com, and today I'll be interviewing Jules from IKEAHackers.net. Did I get it right? .net, right?
Yes, .com.
Was the .com taken?
Yes, it was taken.
Who took it? So what? Are they doing anything with it?
No, I guess they were trying to.
I think you should go after them. Like, it's like your trademark now.
No, I think IKEA went after them.
Tell us about yourself. Tell us what you do.
Well, I have been managing the blog IKEA Hackers for the last 8 years. I receive all the different IKEA hacks from people who have done something to their IKEA furniture. If it's suitable, then I will be posting it up to the blog and showing it to the world. And I wanted some level of anonymity, so I was flipping through the IKEA catalog and thinking, oh, maybe I could find a name there, and I came across Jules, which happened to be this
Jules
chair. I managed the blog full time.
Serious? So it's a whole profession by itself.
I need to update it. Sometimes I need to, touch up the photos. I need to answer emails and
support. Serious?
Yeah, there are people who actually
Email you and ask.
Yeah, they do have questions. Yeah. On average, I get about 30,000 visitors. Half of my traffic comes from the US.
Half.
Yeah. The rest are from European countries, Australia, the Middle East, So I think anywhere that has IKEA presence, you will find people coming to my site.
Okay, it's been 8 years, right? 8 years. And I know you suddenly got an email from IKEA saying that, okay, you can't use the word IKEA, you have to take down the ads. How do you feel when that happened?
I think that was one of the most horrible day of my life.
Did IKEA Malaysia contact you?
No. I mean, there are PR agencies and advertising agencies have contacted me before, but those were more like, hey, I have this new product or some press release that they would like me to publicize. But it was never official communication from Inter IKEA Systems.
Never heard officially from them at all.
No.
Until the legal.
Yeah. A C&D, a cease and desist, is not exactly a legal letter.
It's like, stop doing that.
Yeah. Okay. I think I needed to explain to my readers because.
Why you would stop?
Why you stopped doing
updates for a few days?
No, I didn't stop.
Alright.
Okay. The domain was to be moved to another site, I need to explain what happened. Or like a treasure trove of so many hacks that I've compiled over the years. I think I have maybe more than 4,000 or maybe 5,000 hacks on the site.
That's a lot.
To just let it all go, it's such a waste,
Even IKEA's own Pinterest site did use some of your pictures. Like, was that one? What was the reaction like from the public? What happened? What did your readers say? I know some tech blogs wrote about it.
I had expected a certain level of support from my readers, but the outpouring of support was totally tremendous, was astonishing, right? It appeared on Wall Street Journal.
Wow, it doesn't get better than that.
BBC, locally, Malaysia, like 6 days after the announcement, I received an email from a representative from IKEA, and they wanted to contact me so that they can explore and discuss how to move forward in this unfortunate situation. The C&D is from their agency, who handles this kind of trademark
But so that means basically legal did not talk to PR or something like that.
I don't really know.
I really hope that's the case, not someone changing their mind or something like that. Do you think like as part of the apology you get like a lifetime year supply of IKEA furniture or something? And balls and luck and everything.
Anything is possible, I guess.
Is there anything you want to say right to them? Like the readers?
I really would like to say thank you. I think without your support, the whole situation would not have turned around. I want to continue to do my best for this community, to be able to showcase even more creative acts and help you to inspire you to create a beautiful living space for yourself.
All right, that's good. Hey, thanks so much for the interview.
Thanks, Josh.
All right, so, well, I guess you're being happy, right? Good Friday.
Yes,
yeah?
I am.
Yeah?
Very happy. And thank
okay,
you so much.
So keep on hacking, right?
I will.
Okay.